Hi everyone, welcome to World of Tanks with stewiejp. I'm Stewie and this is the Tier 7 Premium Tank Destroyer, the E25, the very controversial tank which Wargaming once said that never sell again, but here we go. They've sold it again and today it's been driven by Bo B. Bo B, just like me, bought one when the opportunity arose to buy this overpowered Tier 7 German Tank Destroyer, and he's doing a bit of boosting. Look out, we're on the Tundra map and he's platooned up with his old mate Leak Gamer, or from Think Clan, Bo B. I think he's in Think Clan now, and he's doing a bit of boost up at A8 on Tundra, looking for a few cheeky snipey shots into whatever enemy tanks might be pushing the hill, looking for some shots on that AMX ELC, but I think that AMX ELC might be on the other side of that ridge line. There he is, puts a shot in too, and look at the rate of fire in this Tank Destroyer. Probably should have went for the Hellcat, but it doesn't really matter because the gun reloads really quick. Look how fast that gun just pew 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 fires away at those enemy tanks as he gets another shot into the Hellcat. And that shot, unlucky not to penetrate it, but this shot will go through. Can he get another one in? He can. And look, he's no longer spotted. But I reckon that last shot might have went through as well. Of course, with standard rounds, the 75mm gun does 135 average damage a shot. With 150mm penetration, 194mm penetration for the APCR rounds, which are the gold rounds. You can see that Bo B is running chocolate in his German Tank Destroyer. And now he's looking to try and chip away at that KV-2 with his big Russian derp gun. Gets a shot into it. Of course, KV-2, not known for its speed. Hits a set, shoots him, sets him on fire, and sends the Tier 6 Russian heavy tank back to the garage. Two alls the score. He's already picked up 852 hit points of damage. And now he's hoping those enemy tanks have another crack at the hill. But looking at the mini-map, there's some top-tier tanks over there on the hill. Of course, Bo B's top-tier in this game as well. But the Tiger P, as well as the Chi-Ri, are up there, sort of dissuading those enemy tanks from taking the hill. But the other side of the map's a totally different story. With the score on 3-4, Bo B is looking at those tanks that are pushing aggressively up the western part of the map. Looking around like a madman, looking at what's going to be the best target. That shot looks like it hit the Tiger 1 on the gun and bounced, and puts another shot into the T7 German heavy tank. Now he's looking at that M4, who is, looks like he's the only tank capping, but doesn't have shots at him, so he starts to chip away at the Chi-Ri, the top tier Japanese medium tank. Puts a few shells into the T67, takes him down to a one shot, just misses the kill shot on the T67. Still just a one tank capping as BB picks up his third kill on the T43 Russian medium tank. And now it's time. He's only got APCR rounds left, and this is probably the only disadvantage of the E25, is it doesn't really have a great amount of ammunition in its capacity. And he just farms damage on that Tiger 1. And now the T29's going to make himself a target. So Bo B is just going to chip away at the Tier 7, to a top tier American heavy tank. Of course, it is known for its armor, the T29. But the SC-25 is chipping away very, very nicely. There's only 12 seconds left on the cap, but maybe unlucky, not lucky enough to pick up the kill on that tank. With 3 seconds left on the cap timer, he gets a couple of shots into the M4, takes him down to a one shot. You can see he's already done 3,660 hit points of damage, but he's only got 9 rounds left, and with the score on 9-11, he might need more than those 9 rounds to finish off the game. One of his teammates puts a shot into the Chi-Ri, and Bo B picks up the kill. also gets a kill on the T-67, and then the J-Panther picks up the M4, which was the other tank that was capping. Now, with only six shells left, there's only two enemy tanks, so maybe I was wrong with how much ammunition the thing carries, but of course, if you're having a ripper game like this, 3,758 hit points of damage, that's an absolute ripper game in the E25. But he's on five kills, and he would dearly like a 6-1. There it is. There's the Top Gun. And now the score is 14-11, and he just wants to get some more damage into the back of that SU-100, the Tier 6 Soviet tank destroyer, who's got two kills. So on almost full health, he's still got 675 health, so he can afford to take a shot in the face from the Russian tank destroyer. And now with his last premium round, he picks up his seventh kill and ends up winning ends up winning a pretty tight game, 15-11, as we have a quick look at the post-game battle results. It won't come as any surprise. He's picked himself up an ace tanker for that action-packed replay, a bruiser, arsonist, fire for effect, a defender medal for reducing the enemy cap points by at least 70, the high caliber, and of course the Top Gun for picking up all those kills. As we look at the second page, 4,673 hit points of damage, 7 kills, 1,504 base experience, and that was enough for an ace tanker mastery badge. Fired 58 shots, 45 hit, and 36 did damage, and he also did 100 reset points. Not a bad result at all. Only made 8,500 credits with a premium account. Of course, all that APCR would have cost him quite a few credits, cost him 81,000 credits for that, but not a bad game at all in the E25, the T7 premium German tank destroyer. As we move on to the second game of this double shot of T7 German tank destroyer action. This one comes from the YouTube gamer from Banff Clan. Again, lucky enough to be top tier in this game. And the YouTube gamer is carrying 45 rounds of AP, 15 rounds of APCR, and when you're top tier, those AP rounds would probably be enough. Now, we saw in the first game how the tank could come quite close to running out of ammunition, even though it carries 60 rounds. When you're firing so fast like Bo B was in that first game, it can be quite easy to run out. It's never happened to me. I haven't had a great amount of the games in the E25, but you know, it's YouTube gamer searching for some shots on that T-67. Someone put a whopping massive amount of damage into that T-67, and YouTube gamer's picked up the kill. Looks like he's trying to shoot some of those buildings down, but those red ones are certainly not destructible. Looks behind him and realizes all these tanks are, what are they doing? They're using him as cover. I don't know. One zip is a score, and a YouTube gamer looking to get some snipey snipe shots onto the enemy tanks in the town. VK85 on the enemy side, doing the right thing and going right up along the back of that one line to avoid being sniped from that hill. A little bit of a wait at this stage of the battle. It's the battle line, Live Oaks. A little bit of chat on in the in-game, basically saying, look how many people have gone to town, and looking at how many enemy tanks from the southeast. So, you know, those medium tanks, quite rightfully, aren't going to try and push the southeast. There's what looks like there's six or eight enemy tanks on the southeast flank of Live Oaks, and that VK30. 01P doing a bit of tank, a bit of pinging the STRV, blaming his team. That's what seems to happen. But look, two alls the score, 2-3 now. And that STRV starting to get into a bit of a panic and starting to ping the map and call everybody noobs and all that kind of really exciting stuff that we see in World of Tanks on the Asian server. But look at the mini map. There's millions of tanks back on the southeastern flank, with the score on 3-4, and they've pushed right aggressively all the way up towards the YouTube gamer's cap. I'm not really sure what the YouTube gamer is doing right now. For a minute I thought there that I'd paused the replay. It looks like he... Maybe, I don't know if he had to go AFK there or not. No idea. What am I doing? I'm just going to fast forward a bit here. Looks like he might have been AFK for a little bit. Now looks like he's back into the game and he's trying to get some shots into the Crusader. Maybe he got a little bit of lag there. That tank seems to be moving very, very slowly. Just worked. Sorry about that, folks. Just worked out what happened. I think I pushed the slowdown button. Anyway, 6-5's the score. YouTube gamer in his E25's picked himself up 2 kills, and he wants to build on that. And he's looking for some shots on that Tiger P. Doesn't manage to penetrate the Tiger P too much. Gets one shell into him, and the score on 8-5 after that. Massive push by the enemy side. The enemy just didn't push into that southern, push into the YouTube gamer's cap very well at all. And basically got cleaned up. IS2, which is where YouTube gamer's been aiming towards for a little bit. The IS2, last spotted right here, there he is. And of course that's what everyone's worried about, the top tier Russian heavy tank. As the Tiger and the Skoda push onto that Chiri, they really want to get that top tier Japanese medium tank out of the game. YouTube Gamer trying to get some height so he can get some shots into the Chiri, but doesn't seem to be working. The IS2's just fired. Is the YouTube Gunner going to get a shot into him? He's not. That IS2 is the danger tank. That's what's keeping everybody lit for whoever else might be back down there. And he is on full health, or he was on full health, as YouTube Gamer puts a shot into the side of his turret, and he doesn't seem to be focusing on the YouTube Gamer too much. So why not just make the most and put some shells into that Russian heavy tank. 10-6 is the score now, as people start to ping the map to go back towards the base. And so YouTube Gamer is going with everybody else back to where the Leo and the M4 were last spotted. And of course they're going to want to get rid of the Leo first if they can, the top tier Swedish medium tank. It's a tank I didn't actually mind playing too much. A lot of people said it wasn't much of a tank. I didn't mind it too much at all. I thought it was pretty fun, especially once you got the top engine and the top gun. And I know a lot of people like playing it with the smaller gun, but the big gun's pretty fun too. Puts another couple of shots into the M4. And with a score on 11-8, they're going searching for that Tier 7 Leo, as well as the VK-2801 and that M4 A3E2. 11-8 to score, 1,678 hit points of damage so far. And the T-50, I'd forgotten all about the T-50. T-6 Russian heavy tank camping the base like there's no tomorrow. No longer lit, so the YouTube gamer puts a couple of blind shots into where he was last spotted. Not sure if any of those land. Actually, I do. I know they did land some. And then he joins the push back along the southeastern flank. Searching for some shots. Hoping to get vision on that T-150. I think that Skoda T-25 would have him lit pretty soon. But the YouTube gamer may as well cross the bridge, because he is a fair way back. There is that Leo being spotted on the other side of the map. So you'd think that these tanks should be able to comfortably get rid of that T-50. That's an interesting little position. The YouTube gamer picks up his 3rd kill of the match. shooting under those railway carriages. Of course, the E25 is so low profile, you can get away with doing those. And if you can't, you can just climb up it. I know what you're thinking, and I agree with you. It's probably the time to snipe is probably over with the score on 12-9. I think the YouTube gamer probably really should have got stuck in a little bit more. But he is on a mission to try and do 3,000 hit points of damage. Not so accurate. I find the gun quite accurate, but obviously, maybe it's not that accurate at range. YouTube gamer in his E25 is the only top tier tank left on the side, and look, that's Skoda T25 and the STRV on reasonably low health, so it's probably they're probably waiting for the E25 to start moving a little bit forward with its good camo values. Of course, that's the thing that people weren't too happy with the E25 when it was re-released, when there was changes to tank destroyers some years ago. The tank destroyers used to have a better camouflage rating, especially when they fired. And all tank destroyers lost it except for premium tank destroyers like the E25. VK gets lit by the YouTube gamer and also lights him, so now the YouTube gamer needs to start using his mobility, which is what he's doing. He's got this Leo on 1100 hit points. Cops a high explosive shell by the looks of it from that T6 American medium tank, but the rate of fire is just going to start carving up this Leo. Does cop a couple of shells, he's down to 193 hit points. Looks like that M4 fired in his direction. Gives him a little bit of a nudge. One more shot will do it. Can he survive it? Yes, he can. And that M4, for some reason, not really focusing on the STRV that's engaging him. He's more so focusing on the YouTube gamer in the E25 on 5 kills. Can he pick up a 6 kill for a top gun? He might be able to do this and stay invisible. He looks like he's looking towards him. He does get lit. Shoots him for 159, leaves him on 13 hit points, and YouTube Gamer wants to turn this into a top gun, and he finally does. Even though it was a little bit of a different game, that one, it was still not a bad result for the YouTube Gamer in his E25. Didn't quite pick himself up an Ace Tanker Mastery Badge, but he got the high caliber and the top gun, and he did 3,520 hit points of damage, 6 kills, 1328 base experience, and he did a little bit of spotting damage, but reasonably profitable game as well. Nearly 14,000 credits after tax with a standard account would have been a bit over 40,000 credits. That's the difference in the two games, firing APCR and firing standard rounds, but not a bad couple of games in the E25, the Tier 7 German Premium Tank Destroyer. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for the replays, lads. Thanks for watching. Take care and see you all next time.